Let's get on Zoom now and speak to our Upper East Region correspondent Castro Senyala for more details on this. Castro, the situation in Boku, we know, has obviously become a worry for everyone. Tell us, has the task force spoken about the kinds of preparations that have been put in place ahead of the December 7 elections?
Right, Park, we see. The election task force has not really been forthcoming as far as preparations or plans for the elections in Boko is concerned. But one thing they have been very clear on is the fact that they will deal ruthlessly with troublemongers, or those who would want to come to the polling stations to foment trouble. Park, we see. Another thing to note is that even though they haven't made their plans or preparedness clear, one thing we've observed as security journalists have observed is that a lot more men from both the police and that of the military have been brought into Boko, aside from those that are in Boko keeping the peace. And that is a clear indication that the military and the police are not leaving any stone unturned as far as ensuring that peace is in Boko and residents are able to go out to vote in their numbers.
And so how would you describe the general security situation there?
Right. Apart from Boko, where we continue to record pockets of gunshots in the night and even in the mornings, the rest of the region is generally very calm, from the Narongo area to the Sandema to even sometimes in Garu and other places are very calm, apart from Boko, where the epicenter of the trouble continues to boil. But then the assurance from the security agencies, the military and that of the police, I mean, led by the regional police commander, DCOP Raymond Wejong Edufiem, shows that, yes, indeed, the security agencies are prepared and will provide that conducive environment that the residents of Boko especially have been calling on security agencies to up their game. Also, the security agencies have also been very clear that they will line up a lot more men on the highways, Borga to Boko, and that of Borga to Walawali and Tamale. And as we speak now, it is evident on the ground that a lot more is being done on the highways.